Let me tell you, my brother, the world is going to see what's going to happen to your man. Your man will get his head boxed off and stopped at will, my pal. Don't you worry about that. And if I'm wrong, me and you will fight straight after.
Welcome back, ladies, gents and Pikachus. Just a little fun video today. I don't know whether you've seen the video of John Fury offering Mike Tyson out on stage for a fight. That was quite good fun. But he's getting a lot of criticism, right? Which, fair enough, like, John Fury, he's a bit of an idiot.
Yeah!
Yeah, man! Yeah, get in the grab, mate! Whatever the outcome, me and you will fight!
All day, baby!
Get on there, my brother!
Fine, and he does talk a lot of rubbish. But let's look at the facts here. That's what I always try to do, look at the facts, right? This is the fight. Tyson Fury versus Francis Ngannou.
In the new heavyweight champion of the world!
Tyson Fury! The man of all men!
On paper, it's a great fight. But on TV, Francis Ngannou is not an entertainer. He is legitimately just a fighter. It's not that entertaining. John Fury is a clever guy. He's spotted straight away. Francis Ngannou is the heel, but he doesn't talk. There's going to be no promotion of the fight if there's no heel. So guess what? John Fury steps up and provides one of the best heel performances we'll ever see.
A man what can't be equal!
Francis,
my son!
And my thing.
My right son!
Ngannou. I said it right that time, didn't I?
Ngannou couldn't beat me, Mike. Ngannou can't beat me, pal. And I'm useless.
Hey, what are you
but
saying?
I tell you what I've got a world
maybe
cup
not
ass.
You, but your son.
I'm ball to burn! Ball to burn!
What did you say?
I'm ready to go and right now, my brother!
I can beat him. I said maybe not him, but his son.
See you, my mate. Take the glasses off so I can see the fear in your eyes. Take your glasses off so I can see the fear in your eyes. Tell him, Tyson. Put it on him.
No, I'm afraid of you. I'm scared of you. But your son, I'll take you now.
Well, the apology can be accepted and you managed to apologise, so I'll take that as a good luck. But you're going to need it, my brother.
We all need it.
That's right. Beat him up.
He knows. He absolutely knows. Mike Tyson would flatten him in like 4 seconds and he'd be waking up in 4 days. He wouldn't stand a chance against Mike Tyson. I mean, Mike Tyson's not that much older than John Fury. But you can see the condition of John Fury looks terrible, whereas Mike Tyson will batter the hell out of most people, even today, and take on most of today's heavyweights and win. So yeah, the conclusion is...
Well... Let's just get a round of applause for that little exchange. Tremendous.
Let's get this party started! Let's get Saudi Arabia rocking!
Just keep in mind while you're watching John Fury be an idiot that he half of the time he does believe what he's saying. I'm not saying he's not a nutter, but I mean it's clearly a performance there, right? And if you compare that to Conor McGregor when he was hyping up his fight against pretty much any of his big opponents, like there was no holds barred. That guy went beyond what professionalism said you could do.
Let's bring in Mike Tyson. Obviously, there's a possible fight with John Fury one day, but let's talk about this fight going on Saturday night. Francis Ngannou is a man that you are guiding, you are coaching to dethrone Tyson Fury. Tell us your thoughts heading into this fight.
And listen, I thought this was ridiculous too until I saw him spar. You know, I watched him box around, he moved, but when I saw him hit this guy's 6'9", 6'8", big strong. When he hit the guy...
Whereas John Fury, he's just embarrassing himself and making a fuss. And it stands true. If you take away the John Fury parts of the press conference, it's boring. It was a John Fury press conference, so he's got to be proud of himself for that. And the fact that his son is Tyson Fury, as he said. So, yeah, just keep that in mind. Just think, John Fury, he's a bit of an idiot, but, you know, he's not stupid. He did a good job there. So anyway, we look forward to that fight. It's going to be mayhem. It's not going to be a regular boxing fight. It's just going to be a show. Think WWF from the 90s. There's going to be eye pokes. There's going to be ball shots. There's going to be pushing, shoving, wrestling. You know, I wouldn't be surprised if the coaches were like fighting each other outside of the ring. Because it isn't... If that happened in boxing, that'd be the end of the fight. It would just be... The sanctioning bodies wouldn't have it, right? Because it would be too dangerous. But... In Riot Season, in this particular show, it's meant to be entertaining. It isn't meant to be a technical boxing fight. So all that stuff's okay. And John Fury is like, he's literally thrown the first WWF suplex, if you like. So I think it's going to be great fun, and yeah, we'll wait for it to happen before we comment anymore. So I hope you enjoyed that, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
I never saw nothing like that before. Spin said he saw it before. I never saw it. He hit the guy the chin and broke the ankle, the leg. Hey, listen, man.
Oh, Mike Tyson, I do love you as a boxer, but I mean, John Fury's got you beat when it comes to promotion. So let's look forward to that, and I'll see you next time.